Hello everyone. I'm sure you remember that in my previous video, I have already told you or explained how you will be writing a notice. Now today, I'll help you in writing an email. Now this is the format of the email that you'll be following. Now see, please consider this part of your board as your page, your register. Ignore this part. Just look here. The first thing that you need to write is to. To means you'll be writing the email address of the person whom you are inviting. For example, there's a dance competition held in your school and you have to invite the principal of another school. So the email address should always be principal, the name of the school, @gmail.com. Now here you can see that I've written principal SJS @gmail.com. Now you will never write the name of a person in this part. Please make sure you only write the name of the school and the principal. This is important. You're not supposed to write any name in the email address. Now after to, there is no from or date, nothing. You'll come directly to the subject. In the subject, you'll be writing the heading. For example, invitation for the dance competition. So maybe you are inviting the principal of SJS, you know, for the dance competition. So this subject should be a single line. It should not be in two or three lines. You don't have to write a letter here. You just have to write a single line telling the person that this is the heading. This is the subject. For example, invitation for the dance competition. So it is quite clear that you have sent an invitation in order to invite the principal of that school. Now see the second part here. Now after this, you'll be leaving a line here. You have to leave a line to keep it neat and clean. Make sure that you do leave a line here. Then from the next line, you'll start with salutation. Now what is salutation? Dear sir or dear madam. Now in your senior classes, you won't be writing dear ma'am. It is not acceptable as most of the students, they tend to make mistake while writing ma'am. We would prefer and you should write dear sir, madam and a comma, right? I'm sure you can write this much. Please learn the spelling of madam. You don't have to write ma'am. It is not accepted anymore in your boards, right? So please, this is salutation, dear sir or madam. Now it depends. For example, if you know the principal of that particular school is a female, then of course you can write dear madam. Or if you know that the principal is sir, you can always write sir, dear sir, right? So you can choose or you can write both. Now next comes opening sentence. Now opening sentence means the starting of your letter, email. It is just like a formal letter and this opening sentence is very important. For example, here I've written a sentence for you. This is to bring to your kind notice that our school is organizing a dance competition, right? This is how you can start. So this line is very important as you get marks for that. Opening sentence and then you get marks for the closing sentence. Here you can choose any sentence that you're comfortable with. For example, if it is an invitation, you can write, this is to invite you, right? And I would be grateful. This is your closing sentence. Again, you have marks for the closing sentence. So you just cannot ignore the closing sentence and finish your email. No, you have to make sure that you write a closing sentence from a new line, right? It should be, for example, you've written the whole letter. You have mentioned the venue, the details of your dance competition. And then once you've written your motive, you can end the letter by writing, I would be grateful if you could come. You know, you can frame any sentence, but there are marks for the closing of the sentence and for opening of the sentence. So you have to make sure that you do write the closing of the sentence from a new line. Now, after that, again, I would suggest that you leave a line to keep it neat and clean, right? To keep the format clean, leave another line and then you have to write subscription. That means yours faithfully and your complete name, your full name. Is that clear? So you should write your full name. Now, full name means you'll be writing your first name plus your last name. Do not leave it, you know, or do not leave it incomplete. Please do not ignore your last name. It is an official letter, so you have to write your last name as well. Is that clear? So make sure that your salutation and your subscription should be exactly like your formal letter. You are not supposed to make any changes here. Now, if you have a question regarding where do we have to write date, it has to be in the content, in the center, in the para of your email. For example, you've written this and you've written that I'm writing this email to invite you on behalf of my school in the dance competition that would be held in the activity center of St. Jude School. It will be held on a particular date. Again, the date should be within the bracket of 15 days in future. And after that, you'll be mentioning the timings as well. So all the details that you've written in the notice should be copied here. Same details without any mistake. Once you've actually written all the details here, then of course in the next para you'll write the closing of the sentence, then your subscription. So this is the perfect and the permanent format of your email for the boards. Please remember, do not write from, it is always to and subject. To please avoid writing to, from, date, no, it is not accepted. It has to be to, then subject. You'll write it in the same manner, to and subject, colon and the email address plus the subject. Dear sir, dear madam, and this part. Everything will remain same on this hand. This is only for the explanation. Right, so make sure that you do understand. Copy this format in your registers. And I'll be sending one or two examples plus one or two questions so that you can try how to write an email and a notice. In your question paper, there will be a question, question number 3. It will have two parts, A and B. Both are compulsory. Question number 3A will be your notice and question number 3B will be your email. So that means whatever details you'll be writing in the notice will be connected. That means when you write an email, you'll be copying all the details here as well. So question number 3A and B will always be connected, right? So this is how you'll be writing an email. That's it. Thank you.